Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
I don't think I know that song, but I can try.
The first amazing and important night of any kind of footy conference matchup featuring the North Carolina A&T State University Aggies against your Allen University.
Excuse me.
The other guard, 5'10" junior from Dearborn, New York, number one, Aaron Titch Edme. At guard, a 6'2" graduate student from Forest City, North Carolina, number 3, Devontae Boykins. Forward, 6'7" senior from Greenfield, South Carolina, number 0, Devontae Boykins. Bill Ford, 6'8" sophomore from Long Island, New York, number 25, Demi Ojovi. The Aggies are coached by Jay Joyner, associate head coach Jack Augustino, associate coaches Will Jones and Davis Buck.
Play by That works.
Yeah, they're inbounding the ball.
Cross the way. The way is coming back to let you do it.
No good. Rebounded and blocked by Cameron Lewis. Back to Lekmingo. Back to RJ Cole. Back to CJ Williams. And it's a travel on CJ Williams. Howard's clearly upset. And it's timeout, Howard.
And it's been a strong start for the Bison so far. They're playing with some early aggression, looking to get out and run, get some early stops, and try to use that to their advantage.
And Howard always kind of starts very slow at the very beginning of the fourth quarter, so they'll pick it up come second half time, which they're notorious for.
I need to go downstairs and get my shirt at some point.
Right.
This is ridiculous. So we're back live. NT bringing the ball up.
Number 4, Cameron Langley. Back to number 1, Aaron Edmond. Aaron Edmond. Back to number 3, Devontae Boykins. Stolen by Lekmingo. He passes it. Oh, I'm sorry, he doesn't pass it. Passes it to RJ Cole at half court. Back to Lekmingo. And it's a foul on North Carolina A&T, number 30. Number 3, Devontae Boykins. First personal, team second. RJ Cole inbounds the ball, passes it to Cameron Lewis, back to CJ Williams, goes for the 3, no good. Cameron Langley with the ball, down court, goes for the 2, passes it to number 3, Devontae Boykins, no good for the 3. And number 33, North Carolina A&T gets the 2. Inbounded by RJ Cole, back to half court. Goes for the 3, and he's good. Cameron Langley with the ball at half court. Passes it to number 3, Devontae Boykins. North Carolina AT&T, number 33, goes for the 3, no good. Back to RJ Cole and to CJ Williams, stolen by number 33 again, North Carolina AT. And he fouls Lekmingo for Howard.
You good?
In front of Lekmingo. He goes down to half court. Score is 6-14. Aggies losing by 2. Pass it to CJ Williams. CJ tries to go for the 2. And it's no good. Rebound by number 25, Femi Alujuba. Back to number 3, Devontae Boykins. North Carolina AT&T. Back to Cameron Langley with the ball at half court. North Carolina AT&T being guarded by RJ Cole. Goes for the 2. And it's blocked by Zion Cousins for Howard, and he gets a foul, his first personal. Cameron will go for the free throw. Shooting two. He prepares for his first shot, and it's good, despite the boost from the crowd. Gotta love our alma mater, Howard. He goes for another two, and for another one, sorry, and it's good. He's a sharpshooter. I'm not surprised by his stats this season. Howard will inbound the ball. Number five, Marcus Hall, and he's a freshman back to Luke Mingo, senior for Howard. Goes to half court. Luke with the ball, trying to find somebody who's open. Pass it to RJ Cole. Guarded by number one, Aaron Edmond, North Carolina A&T, and he's on him pretty hard, so we'll see what he does with the ball. Passes it to number five, Marcus Hall. Marcus goes for the two, and it's good on the buzzer. Howard, nine. North Carolina A&T, Aggie, six. 12:56 left in the quarter, in the half. Number one, Aaron Edmond, goes for the three, and it's no good. Taken back by Cameron Langley, North Carolina AT&T. He's trying to find somebody to shoot. And it's a travel to Cameron Langley. Howard's ball. Number zero, Howard. Delik will take it out.
That's another turnover forced by this Howard defense. They're doing a good job of that early, trying to get A&T to commit some early mistakes and try and get some easy buckets in transition.
Definitely forcing the pressure, which is Howard's forte, especially in this early in the game. Delik Migo with the ball. In the right corner, C.J. Williams, looking for opportunity to shoot. Pass it to Zion Cousins. Back to R.J. Cole. He goes for the three, and it's no good. Rebounded by number 33, North Carolina A&T. Back to Cameron Langley, North Carolina A&T. Top of the 3-yard line, number 25, Olajuwon. No good. Back to R.J. Cole. Howard takes it down court. In the right corner, he passes it to C.J. Williams. He goes back to R.J. Cole. R.J. backs it back to Marcus Hall, number five for Howard. Back to Luke Mingo. Delik will try to go for the two, and he's fouled. He fouled Cameron Langley. That's his first technical, or first personal, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, it's Marcus Hall's of Howard's first personal. And it's a timeout. 11:53 left in the first half. 9-6. Aggies are losing.
Howard's off to a very strong start. They've hit a number of tough baskets. They're playing some good defense early. Trying to get to their new superstar, RJ Cole. They're the man on campus so far to start the season. What can you say about him? He's a terrific young talent. He's leading the team to scoring and assists. And he's just done a good job of, you know, kind of bringing, infusing some energy to this Howard University basketball program.
And he's been Rookie of the Week a few times. I wanted to see how the transition from high school to college would be, and he does so well. And even with C.J. Williams, who was a former star's talent, they do well together as a duo.
They definitely do. And like you said, he's come off nine MEAC Rookie of the Week awards. So really, he's doing something right if he's earned nine awards to start the season.
Right.
But like you said, he's also doing a good job of being able to play with C.J. Williams. And the two have kind of guided Howard early in this early part of the season. And they're doing a good job doing what they do early. Let the game come to them and try to attack A&T.
Exactly. It'll be an interesting game, though, because North Carolina A&T is 5-0 in the conference. And Howard is 1-4. So what do you think about this game? And it's end goal. What do you think the result will be?
Howard coming off a huge, huge victory against North Carolina Central. And I would like to see them try and build off of that. That was just a huge, huge win for them, I think. They did a good job of pulling it out in overtime, keeping their composure. And that's something, you know, young team struggled with, but they did a good job against a very veteran, very talented North Carolina Central team. And I would like to see them do it again against another tough opponent in A&T, who's had a bit of a bounce back year. They struggled last year in the conference with just 3-29 on the season, but they started the season off reloaded, refreshed, and then looking to make some noise in the MEAC early.
Number 25, Femi Olujobi at the free throw line. He goes for the one, and it's good. For the Bison, number 5, Marcus Hall. He subbed in. Cameron Lewis goes back out to the Howard Bison bench. North Carolina A&T Aggies, number 25, Femi Olujobi goes for the one.
And Howard with their young core in early, Zion Cousins, RJ Cole, and Marcus Hall. Three freshmen who have played very well to start the season.
Good.
But all of them doing great jobs on the different aspects of the game. RJ, of course, bringing scoring and playmaking. Marcus Hall bringing a lot of energy and toughness.
CJ goes for the
three. His body. And Zion Cousins is doing a little bit of everything, being that big man that Howard so desperately needs in order to compete in the MEAC. But it's going to take some time for him to grow, but I like what I see from this young man.
Completely agreed. All the freshmen are doing so well this year. Even Zion Cousins, the big man on campus, he's aggressive.
He
is. For a freshman, he just transferred from high school. He does really well rebounding the ball and kind of forcing that pressure.
Definitely, definitely.
C.J. Williams comes out. Kyle Foster for Howard. We subbed in. Marcus Hall inbounded from R.J. Cole. R.J. goes for the three, and it's no good. Kyle Foster inbound the ball for Howard. Inbounds it to at half court to Marcus Hall. Marcus Hall passes to R.J. Cole at half court. Will R.J. pass or will he shoot? He goes to middle of the court in the right corner, guarded by Cameron Langley. Passes it to number 0 for Howard, Blake Mingo. Back to Zion Cousins. Back to Kyle Foster, the freshman. He goes for the 2, and it's good. Cameron Langley the ball at half court. Passing number 33 for North Carolina A&T. And he fouls Zion Cousins. That'll be his first personal. Denzel Keys is his name. And I've been so interested in this game so far because with the 1-4 record, you really don't know what to expect. But Howard is always surprising us. They're a hard team. They're an aggressive team. And with a score like this so far, and they're so early in the game, 11-8, it'll be interesting to see how the game ends. Kyle Foster with the ball. And he's fouled by number 21, Jafet Kaji, his first personal. Blake Mingo will inbound the ball. Howard. Inbounds it to Marcus Hall, number 5 for Howard. Passes it to RJ Cole, half court. He'll take it down court. He'll go for the 2. And it's good. And he's fouled by number 1, DeVaris McGowan. I'm sorry, for Aaron Edmond for North Carolina A&T. His first personal, team 7. At the free throw line for the Bisons, RJ Cole shooting 1. And it's no good. Rebounded by number 0, DeVaris McGowan. Cameron Lane, we take it down court, guarded by RJ Cole. We'll see how this matchup goes. They're both two very aggressive players, and he blocks it. Check into the ball game for the Aggies, number 14. Raymond Pratt.
And Howard's brought in another one of their young freshmen, Kyle Foster. Young man who's been shooting the ball very well to start the season. He's been another nice pickup for the Bison.
Completely. For a younger team, they do really well.
They are. Definitely a bit of a transition coming from last year's veteran squad to this much, much younger team, but we'll see how they develop.
Pass to CJ Williams for the three, and it's good. And a swish at that. Howard. 16, the Aggies 8. North Carolina 18 bring it back by Raymond Pratt for the two. RJ Cole at half court for the Bison, goes for the three, and it's no good. Kyle Foster rebounds it, passes it to CJ Williams at half court. Back to RJ Cole, guarded by number one Aaron Edmead. RJ goes to the right corner, the court passes back to Marcus Hall. Back to RJ Cole for Howard, goes for the two. Passes it back to Marcus Hall, goes for the two, and it's good. Raymond Pratt would take it down court, goes for the two, and it's no good. And it's a foul against Marcus Hall, his second personal, team seventh. Femi Olojobi will go for the one, for the two. We'll go for the one right now. Shooting one. Femi prepares for his one. At the free throw line. The Howard crowd's looking pretty aggressive. And it's good.
Thank you.
And the first free throw is good by RJ Cole. And that puts the Bison up 19-12 with 8:22 left to go in the first half. Cole lines up for the second free throw. And the second free throw was good by Cole. A&T brings the ball up, working from left to right. Ball coming in the hands of junior guard Aaron Edmead. A&T working against Howard's 3-2 zone. Tough rebound by A&C, and a foul is called on Howard. And there's a timeout on the floor. 7:52 left to go in the first half. The Bison lead the Aggies 20-12. And we are back live, 7:52 left to go in the first half. The Bison currently lead the Aggies 20-12. And DeForest McGowan is currently at the line for the Aggies. And McGowan is off on the first free throw attempt. And he's good on the second one, and that pulls the Aggies within 7 points. And Delik Mingo brings the ball up. He's working against Aaron Edmead. Point attempt is good by Kyle Foster.
For Cameron Langley, back number one, Aaron Edmead. Kyle
and
Foster Edmund
Garrigan. Working against Foster.
Number 14, Raymond Pratt. Back number 25, Finney Olujobi. Those are the two, and it's good.
And a strong take there by Finney Olujobi.
Back to Luke Mingo at half court, passes it to CJ Williams, goes for the three, and it's good! Going back to Luke Mingo. And he fouls number four, Cameron Langley.
Oh.
And that right there is that's a huge energy swing for the Bison.
Right. That technical changes the momentum completely.
That technical foul call on ANC, that's a big call right there with 6:45 left to go in the first half.
And it gets really interesting in this type of quarter because it's really high pace, very, very high intensity. Temperatures are rising. You know how the boys be boys. And this technical foul just kind of speaks to the momentum of the Howard team. They're forcing the pressure. It's causing a lot of agitation. Boys are getting very, very frustrated for North Carolina A&T, and it's obvious.
Definitely, definitely. I agree with you there, Kalen. And while we have a moment here, I think there's the other big thing that's really helped the Bison so far to start this game is the energy they're receiving from the crowd.
Yeah.
They're playing in front of their first near capacity crowd of the season, and I think that's allowed them to kind of play loose, play freely, and allow them to get out and run, which is what you would like to see from a young team.
I agree. And it's org night. Everybody's here to support.
It is. It's all love here at Howard University.
The Mecca. You don't want to miss it. C.J. Williams at free throw line, goes for the one. And it's good. C.J. Williams goes for the one. Again. And it's good. Howard 28, North Carolina A&T Aggies 15. 6:45 left in the first half. Kyle Foster will inbound the ball. North Carolina A&T, Quay Lardy, back to number four, Cameron Langley, in the left corner of the court. Back to 15 for the three, and it's no good. That was Amari Hamilton for North Carolina A&T, back to RJ Cole for Howard University. Takes it down court, passes it. Passes it to Michael for Howard, and goes good for the two. And that's number, that was number 34,
I like
Michael Bindon.
I like that take there from RJ Cole. Did a good job of attacking the basket and doing what he does best, drawing the defenders to him, and then attacking the basket with that relentless abandon that allows him to create some separation and create space for other players.
Thank you.
Bison doing a good job of defending the ball. Cameron Lincoln, number four. Back to number 22 for North Carolina AT&T. Misses it. Rebounded. Stolen by number 22, North Carolina AT&T. And that was Malik Gant. RJ Cole inbounds the ball, takes it down court. He's at half court right now, being guarded by number two, North Carolina AT&T, Quay Larty. Takes it down court. Goes for the two, and it's good. RJ Cole. Back to number zero. Javaris McGowan's North Carolina AT&T, it's good. Ludmilla inbounds the ball, takes it out. Takes it down court. Article the ball defended by number two, Quay Larty. Goes for the three, no good. Rebounded by Michael Bindu, Howard University. Back to C.J. Williams for the three, and it's no good. Rebounded by RJ Cole. Taken out by Delik Mingo. Goes for the two, and it's good. And one. Timeout, Howard.
And Howard's really getting it after it on the offensive glass. They're doing a good job of getting second chance points and getting them some easy buckets close in the paint.
36-22, 3 minutes left. This has been an aggressive game. Howard is good at one thing and one thing only, pressure. Very good at pressure. And that's just the kind of tone, their tone of the game. And it works very, very well, especially because they're still getting their momentum at the very beginning of the game. They're still trying to learn the game and their opponents. But for the North Carolina A&T Aggies, it's been very, very evident that it's working.
I think they're overwhelmed a little bit by the energy of Howard, who's getting after them on both sides of the court, both offensively and defensively, and allowing that themselves to play off the crowd's energy.
The house is full tonight at the Mecca. It's Org Night, and all of our Org and fraternities stores will be representing tonight for their one and only Howard University. I see the Deltas, I see the Qs, Omega Psi Phi, I see the Noobs, I see the Sigmas, I see the Iotas. The house is full tonight, and a bunch of loving supporters and fans. Back to Delik Mingo at the free throw line for the two. And it's good. Back to Quay Larty. He passes it to number zero, Devaris McGowan. Back to Cameron Langley. Rebounded, stolen by Delik Mingo. Stolen back by RJ Cole. Pass to CJ Williams and dunks. CJ Williams for the two, and it's done. Number four, Cameron Langley. inbound by Larty.
And CJ Williams with a big time finish there, but Howard in transition. He's got 12 so far in the first half and has really helped lead the Bison.
Article inbounds the ball, takes it out down court in the left corner of the court, goes for the two, and it's no good. Rebounded by number 25 for North Carolina A&T. Femi Olujobi, back number 22. Malik Gantz goes for the two, and it's good. Inbounded by Jalen Jones. Pass back to Malik Mingo. He'll take it down court. Timeout, Howard. 2:05 left in the first half, 38-24 Bison. RJ Cole with the ball. Passes it to Kyle Foster for the three, and it's no good. Stolen back behind the back. Ball game for the Bison, number zero, Delik Mingo, sub out for Kyle Foster. Go, Kyle. Let's go, CJ. Let's go, RJ Cole. You know, I'm a Bison fan at heart, so I'm a little biased in this game, but it'll be interesting to see how this plays out. 38-24 Bison in the first half, 1:41 left on the clock. Pass number 22. Back to number zero, DeVars McGowans. Pass number 4, Cameron Langley. Back 25, Femi Olujobi. Blocked. Back number 22 from North Carolina A&T. Goes for the 3, and it's no good. Rebounded by Michael Obindu for Howard University. Taken back by RJ Cole. Goes for the 2. That's no good. Rebounded by number 25, Femi Olujobi. Back to Cameron Langley, back number 2, Quay Larty for the 3, and it's good. One minute left on the clock. Delik Mingo with the ball at half court. He takes it out, back to Michael Obindu. Passes it to RJ Cole. Stolen by Cameron Langley. Goes down to down court for the 2, and it's good. Inbound by Michael Bindu. Pass to Jalen Jones. Delik Mingo with the ball. He'll take it down court. Will he pass or will he shoot? Delik's a very, very funny guy in person, but he's great on the court. He's a diverse player. Langley and RJ getting into it a little bit. Langley's a little aggressive with his defense. Nothing RJ Cole can't handle. Takes it down court for the 2. Passes it to RJ Mingo for the 3. And it's good on the buzzer beater. Howard 41-29. Bison leading. Halftime.
That was a big time shot there by Delik Mingo.
Buzzer beater.
I From the historic region.
Okay. basketball.
Thank you for coming and talk to me. Can you give me your name and tell me a little bit about your organization?
Yes, my name is Tariq Johnson, and I am currently serving as the president of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated Alpha Chapter. Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity is an organization that was founded January 9th, 1914, on the principles of brotherhood, scholarship, and service. And we do our best to exemplify that every day, especially being Alpha Chapter here.
Thank you so much. So can you tell me what's your favorite aspect of coming out to the Org Night basketball game?
Well, I think some of our favorite part is just being out here fellowshipping with the rest of the Howard community, being able to experience the MPAC Greek unity, which doesn't happen much. You know! And just being able to be out here with my brothers and just show the campus what we mean to be Sigmas.
Thank you so much. Go enjoy the rest of the game. Thank you. Thank you for coming out and talking with me this evening. If you don't mind, can you give me your name and tell me a little bit about your organization?
Hi, I'm a member of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, Alpha Chapter. My name is Kiana Chambers.
Thank you. So tell me a little bit about what's your favorite aspect of Org Night.
I think just seeing all the students come together and just, you know, really unite and show that, you know, we love Howard and we love our basketball team. Face the camera. So can we do it over?
Okay.
But yeah, just seeing everybody come together, have a good time, it's really awesome.
Thank you.
No problem.
Why would you do that?
Cal University home game is on Saturday, February 30th, and Stampede, Bison Women and 2, Bison Men will follow by 4. Then it's Sports Day. Again, the next Cal home game, Saturday the 3rd, doubleheader beginning at 2 o'clock right here at...
The score.
And as we get started from the second half, ANC inbounds the ball. They bring it into the front court. So, Kaylin, what were your major takeaways from that first half of play?
That freshman do it all. No, I'm playing. I think it was a really good dynamic. There's just so much momentum with the team, and they're really great with pressure. And, you know, every team starts off slow in the first quarter, but for them to be doing so well with this big impact on the game as far as pressure, as far as tenacity, as far as just drive. It's just a completely different from any other game I've seen them play this season. And mm-hmm. sometimes I will say the fans are really hard on the team. Their record would precede them, but they're just showing that they're just a dynamic team. You never know what to expect, and they're surprising me. They're completely surprising me.
So one of the big things I noticed in this game, I feel like, was the energy level in the first half.
Mm-hmm.
How much do you think that's playing a role for the Bison in this game?
One more time. I'm sorry to hear you.
So I noticed there's a lot of energy in this building right now. Mm-hmm. How do you think that's helping the Bison on both sides of the ball and allow them to jump out to a 12-point halftime lead?
Well, for one, they can't do bad in front of all these people. It's too many people to be, you know, getting punked in front of. But no, on a serious note, I think it just really helps their game and their drive. I mean, they see everybody supporting them. They feel the love. They feel the support. They feel the integrity. And they have something to play for. I mean, every single player has their why. So when you look around, you see, what is this, like maybe 400 people, 200 people?
Here?
Yes. What do you think?
I'd say about 2,000.
2,000 people? You might be right. There's a lot of people in here. So that being the case, they have a why. They have a reason for playing so well and really showing out for this team. And coming off a win last week, I mean, they're fired up anyway, so
yep,
it's good.
Exactly. What about Dalik Mingo? He had a big shot to end the first half.
And a buzzer beater.
Exactly. Like you said. And that, so A&T kind of closed the half a little bit, taking some of the momentum. And then Dalik obviously hit that big shot. Like, what do you think that can help the Bison in the second half if you get started early?
Ask the question one more time, sorry.
So Dalik hit that big buzzer beater to end the first half, and that kind of took away some of the momentum that ANC had over the final minute or so. How well do you think that'll be able to translate to the second half of play?
Two things. They can go really positive, and they can be on that energy and be fired up because of what happened last half, or they can just kind of be a little bit more of a padding for their ego, and they get too comfortable and too excited and not play as well they play the first half. So I'm hoping he takes that first buzzer beater as kind of like the tone for what needs to happen this half compared to letting that inflate his ego. Because then he won't do well, and he'll get too comfortable and too excited and too overly pompous. So there's a negative and a positive to each side, but I think it definitely set the tone. Like I said, it is changing the momentum of the game. When they see constant three, they see constant rebound, they see constant just scoring, and on the team as a whole, it changed the whole dynamic of the game.
I definitely agree, and I think while we're talking about that, I feel like A&T kind of took some of that momentum back. They cut the lead down to six within the first 94 seconds of the first half. And let's see if this young Bison team can kind of weather the storm early in the second half. They did a good job of that in the first half, but, you know, you got to play the game for 40 minutes. I feel like you can't play it for one half. You got to play it the whole time. And we'll see if this young Bison up for the challenge.
And you know what I love so much about the freshmen? Usually when you come from high school and you come from star school, you were star to a school, it's really hard to come be a team player at a school that already has star players, you get what I'm saying? So to see Kyle Foster, to see Zion Cousins, to see RJ Cole come in and work with the team and bond and see the flow, it's amazing to me because there can never be two Kobes, you know? People always think you can never have a Kobe and Shaq type of dynamic duo, but to see that between RJ Cole and C-Day especially is beautiful.
I think definitely is. I think they've done a good job of kind of complementing each other. They're still, obviously, they've only been playing together for half a season and still kind of learning each other's games. But like we said before in the first half, this is a young team. They're going to grow. They're going to make some mistakes. But this is one of those games where they can, you know, get a chance to kind of learn from their experiences.
Exactly.
And see if they can kind of weather this storm that they're getting hit with right now. You know, it'll be a good challenge for these young freshmen. It's only going to help them as they continue to grow and develop as players and as people.
I agree completely. North Carolina A&T ball. Out of bounds by C.J. Williams. They just need to calm down a little bit. I think they're seeing the gap starting to close in the score. I mean, 41 Bison, 35 Aggies. But they need to maintain their composure, relax, and just play their game.
Exactly. There's no need to panic. There's 18 minutes still.
Too much time.
Just relax. Play good defense, you know, share the basketball, and don't try and overthink the game. Just keep it simple.
Exactly. Stolen back by North Carolina Aggies, number 0, DeVaris McGowan, and he's fouled. And I think it's on RJ Cole. I couldn't be wrong.
That's a blocking foul on Dalik Mingo.
Oh, I'm sorry, stand corrected by Dalik Mingo, number 0, Howard.
But it's stuff like that, you know, getting back in transition that they got to do. They want to be able to hold off this Aggie attack right now. The easier way to do that, just get back in transition and make some stops.
At the free throw line, number 0, DeVaris McGowan. He's kind of been a very, very interesting player. He's very aggressive, especially when it comes to shooting. He doesn't really miss, and he's huge. He's huge. DeVaris McGowan, let me see. He's 6'7", 230 pounds. From Greenville, South Carolina.
A little bit of Draymond Green right there.
Exactly. He's a forward for sure. Rebounded by Zion Cousins. Right back to Delique Mingo. He takes it down half court. Left corner of the court. Kyle Foster with the ball. Back to Zion Cousins. In the right corner, CJ Williams. Court right back to Kyle Foster, guarded by Cameron Langley. Cameron goes for it, and no.
So, Kaylin, one of the players that's intrigued me so far in the second half has been Delique Mingo, and he's currently matched up right now against the much smaller Aaron Eadney, bit of a smaller guard, as like they did with RJ in the first half. I would definitely like to try and use some post-ups and try and take advantage of that, you know, size mismatch that they have and create some easy buckets for the Bison and see if they can get some points like that.
I agree.
What do you think about that? So the league obviously had a big first half, and he was, as did RJ, and both of them slightly bigger guards than Aaron Edmund of North Carolina A&T. One of the things I like what the Bison are trying to do is, you know, create mismatches in the post.
Okay. And really quickly, I'm sorry, we have to get a shout out to our wonderful Spotlight Team production. And on live, we have Marissa, the wonderful Marissa. She's the reporter for Spotlight. So shout out to Spotlight for Howard Television.
Takes a couple of days.
Let me go for the two. No good. There's a foul. North Carolina A&T. Number 33, Denzel Keys. His third personal team, second.
Thank you.
Checking into the ballgame for the Aggies, number zero, Damaris McGowan. Inbounded by Cameron Lewis, back to Luke Mingo, number zero. He'll take it down court, guarded by number one, Aaron Edmead for North Carolina A&T. Pass back to Cameron Lewis.
This is one of the match.
Stolen by number two, Kwai Larty for the two, and it's good.
So, Kaylin. Boris McGowan is currently at the line for the Aggies. And he's off on the first free throw.
Zion Cousins.
So, Kaylin, one of the big problems I've noticed so far to start this second half has been the turnovers. Howard has turned it over several times over the last couple of minutes, and it's kind of allowing some of the momentum to shift towards A&T. What do you think they can do to try and correct that issue as the game starts to wind down a little bit and moving the crunch
time? Slow it down. They'd have to slow it down. There's too much intensity. They're moving too fast. They're not communicating too well. And A&T has definitely went to the locker room, rethought what they did and step up their defense. So they just have to slow it down and really just pace themselves.
Agreed.
Charles Williams with the ball, taking it down court. Number 13 goes for the two. Back is Zion Williams, and it's good. For the two. Bison in the lead, 14-24 left on the clock in the half. Cameron Langley with the ball, pass back to number zero, Devaris McGowan in the right corner of the court, guarded by Kyle Foster, right back to number zero.
and he goes for the two, and it's locked. Back at 25, Cameron Lewis, back to RJ Cole, take it down the court, pass it to Kyle Foster, and it's passed and stolen by Cameron Laney, number two, down the court, takes it to Martha Gowan for the two, and it's good. RJ Cole inbounds the ball, takes down court, guarded by number one, Aaron Edmead. Nice screen by Cameron Lewis. And he's fouled. Anti-foul charge, number one, Aaron Edmead. Team fourth. Mingo checking into the ball game, setting up for Kyle Foster. Ball and it's a foul on the right corner between Charles William for Howard and A&T number 15 Amari Hamilton, and it's a charge on Amari Hamilton, his first. Blake Mingo will inbound the ball to Cameron Lewis at half court, pass it to RJ Cole. RJ Cole takes it down court. He's guarded by Cameron Langley. Goes for the two and it's blocked. Zion Cousin rebounds it. Passes it to RJ Cole for the three. No good. Rebounded by number 25, Samuel Ojoboe. Cameron Langley goes for the three and it's no good. Dilly Mingo with the ball. At half court, pass to RJ Cole. Takes it down court for the three. RJ Cole, and it's good. Cameron Langley with the ball at a half court, guarded by RJ Cole. Pass it to number 15, Amari Hamilton, goes for the two, and it's good. Power foul charge number 13, CJ Williams, his second personal team. At the free throw line for the Aggies, number 15, Amari Hamilton. The score is 51-43 Bison. 12:43 on the clock. Please go inbound the ball to Cameron Lewis. RJ Cole takes it down court. Cameron Lewis with the ball. Delete Mingo with the ball. CJ Williams goes for the three. No good. Cameron Langley goes down court, goes for the two. And one. Power foul charge, Delete Mingo. His third personal.
And that is two more fast break points there and points off turnovers for A&T, and I think that's playing a big role in allowing them to kind of come back from this game.
Completely. If you ever heard the saying, we're shooting ourselves in the foot.
Exactly.
Rebounded by Delik Mingo.
Some of that is the Bison's inexperience due to the fact that it's just a young conference schedule, but it's a correctable issue.
RJ Cole at half court. Takes it down court, passes it to Leek Mingo. Goes for the two, and it's good. Cameron Langley with the ball, passes it to Hempstead, back to DeVarge McGowan. Foul charge, number 10, Zion Cousins, his third personal. Timeout on the floor. RJ Cole goes for the two. He's fouled by number 25, Femi Olujobi. A&T. To Marcus Hall. Back to Zion Cousins. Pass it to RJ Cole for the three. And that's good. Cameron Langley bringing down court. At half court, Pars, he passes it to number two, Quay Larty. Back at 25, Femi Olujobi. Back at 15, Amari Hamilton. Back to Cameron Langley in the left corner of the court. Back to Denzel Keys, goes for the two. No good. Rebound by number 25. Back to Cameron Langley. Back to Mari Hamilton for the three. It's no good. Rebounded again by number 25. And stopped by Zion Cousin. And it's a foul to number 25. Femi Olujobi, second personal. Go with the ball in the right corner of the court. Pass it to RJ Cole, guarded by Cameron Langley. Take it to two. And it's good. RJ Cole, power. Cameron Langley takes out the ball to half court.
And Taylor.
He'll pass it to Quay Larty, back at 33. Denzel Keys. Back to Cameron Langley again. Back to Mari Hamilton for the two, and it's good. RJ Cole take it down court. Back to CJ Williams, left side of the court. He's guarded by number 15, Mari Hamilton. Back to Delik Mingo. Back to RJ Cole, left side of the court. back to Lamingo for the three. No good. Stopped by 25 of A&T, Femi Olajobi. Back to Cameron Langley at half court. Back to number 33, Dindo Keith. Back to Amari Hamilton for the three. Carolina A&T, no good. Back to Cameron Langley, they rebound at A&T. He'll call for help to Denzel Keys, back to Amari Hamilton. As a timeout, North Carolina A&T Aggies. For the three, and it's no good. Rebounds it, number three. Stopped by Zion Cousins. Taken back out by RJ Cole, down court. He'll pass to Kyle Foster. Foster will go for the three, no good. Power foul charge to C.J. Williams, his third personal. 58-48, Bison. Aggies are losing by 10. 8:44 left in the half. Cameron Langley will take out the ball for North Carolina A&T Aggies. He's at half court. He'll pass it to number one, Aaron Edmead. Edney will go for the three. No good. Stop by Zion Cousins. Rebound by Zion Cousins, sorry. Back to RJ Cole, take it down court. For the three. No good. Stop by Cameron Langley. Pass it back to DeVaris McGowans. And back to Devontae Boykins. And it's good. Jordan Lee. RJ Cole taking down court. Back Cameron Lewis.
What's your basketball IQ like?
about with conversation. And it's because with conversation, people can tell. Like people who don't know basketball, yeah. They can tell that you're talking about it doesn't.
Right.
So just really just state the facts. You know, just like news reporting. Just state exactly what's happening. And then just, you know.
Like you're saying, taking it down for it and then half court and things like that. Okay.
Yeah, RJ's bringing the ball up court. But you don't have to say, keep saying that because he's a point guard. He's going to bring the ball up the court every time. That's his job to do. But just think of when I like fouls, you always want to talk about fouls. You know, a foul on number four, tell what a foul is. Like, okay, foul on number one, that's his third, you know, that's his third personal. That's when you want to look. Blocks, steals, you can talk about a dunk. You know, you can talk about a good dunk from so-and-so. Okay. You know, stuff like that.
Gotcha. All right. Thank you. Cameron Langley, the ball, takes it up court, passes it to number one, Aaron Edmead. Goes for the three, and it's good. A&T, back in the game, 58-54, Bison lead by
time,
four.
That's a big time three there by the Aggies, off that poor transition defense by the Bison.
And what did we mention first half? Maintaining the composure and the tone of the game.
Exactly. You can't have breakdowns like that, especially this late, this point in the game, when you're getting attacked like that. You just don't want to make those types of mental mistakes.
Exactly.
Those are what can hurt teams.
Okay.
No worries. And C.J. Williams hits the first free throw. That puts the Bison up 59-54, 7:18 left to go in regulation. And C.J. is off on the second free throw, rebounded by the Aggies. They bring the ball across the timeline. And the Aggies secure the offensive rebound there. They reset it up at the top and work it inside. And the offensive foul is called on DeVaris McGowans. And the Bison worked the ball into R.J. Cole. Nice spin move in the paint. He can't quite finish it at the rim. Aggies ball, 6:25 left to go in regulation. Is good by the Aggies. They pull within just 3 points with 6:09 left to go, and they have rallied down some 16 points down in the first half. And RJ Cole off on the three-point attempt. And a great steal there by Cole. Brings the ball up court, and he finds the lead Mingo and Cameron Lewis. Can't quite get the hang of it, and the ball goes out of bounds. Okay. Ball inbounded to freshman Kyle Foster. They recess the ball up in the slot. And one is caught by Zion Cousins. He gets the layup in the paint there. And that puts the Bison up by five. Great finish there by the freshman. And they'll go to the line for a chance to complete the three-point play. And he's off on the free throw attempt. Howard up five, 5:29 left to go in regulation. And Howard can't secure the offensive rebound there. Aggies get the ball back. Gowans is off there on the short jumper. Howard clears the rebound. They get it to RJ Cole. He brings it across the timeline. He's guarded at the top of the key by Clay Larty. And Cole using the screen there by Cameron Lewis. He gets the ball, swings the ball to Zion Cousins. They get it to CJ Williams. Williams with a step back jumper and is off the mark. The rebound by Cole. He finds Cameron Lewis for the lay-in. The Bison lead by seven with 4:27 left to go in regulation. And Larty can't get an answer of his own. Bison basketball. Excuse me, Aggie basketball. Gowans gets the ball in the corner. He swings it to Langley. Free throw is off there by Cameron Langley. And a near steal by the Aggies. Cole brings the ball up, working from left to right. He works around the screen there from Cameron Lewis. He's got Langley, takes the ball to the basket, and they can't quite finish. The rebound there by Lewis, swings it out to Foster, and Foster's good on the three-point attempt. Bison up 10 with 3:35 left to go in regulation, 66-56. Timeout on the floor. And we return back to the berth. 3:35 left to go in regulation. Howard up 66-56. ANC inbounds the ball in their own side of the court. It's inbound to Aaron Edmead. And he's picked up by RJ Cole at the top of the key. They swing the ball to Boykins. It works around him, Gallant's pick. And Femi Olujobi with the easy bucket in the paint that pulls the Aggies within eight. Cole brings the ball up court. And Foster on the three-point attempt and is off the mark. With the rebound back to Lewis. Aggies get possession. And the blocking foul is called on Kyle Foster. And that will send Malik Gantz to the line for two free throws. With a chance to make it a two-possession game with 2:38 to go in regulation. And the first free throw is good there by Gantz. And he hits the second free throw. And that pulls the Aggies within just 6 points with 2:38 to go. And the ball nearly turned over there by the Bison. Cousins sets the inbound. He finds Cameron Lewis. Lewis hands with the handoff there to Cole. He finds C.J. Williams, he's off on a three-point attempt. A&T secures the rebound. And Gantz with the layup in transition. It is a four-point game with 2:20 to go left in regulation. Foster brings the ball up court. Foul's called on Devontae Boykins, and that will send RJ Cole to the line. Cole at the line for two free throws. First one is on the mark. Bison up 67-62, 1:58 left to go in regulation. And Cole back at the line for the second free throw with a chance to make it a two-possession game. And he's good on the free throw. Gans with the ball. He works, drives on C.J. Williams. Finds McGowan's. And McGowan's is fouled by Cameron Lewis. And he'll go to the line for a pair of free throws with a chance to cut it to a four-point game. And McGowan's having a big game. He's got a double-double with 11 points, got 10 rebounds, and he's done a good job of carrying this A&T team in the second half with his energy, been aggressive, crashing the boards, and doing all the little things to help his team win. And he's going the free throw. And he's good on the second free throw. And the Bison have their lead cut down to 4 points, 68-64, 1:48 left to go in regulation. Mingo inbounds the ball to Cole. And finds back to Mingo. Cole swings the ball to CJ, who swings it right back. And a little two-man game between the two guards. RJ finds Cam. Cam swings it out to CJ. CJ's three-point is off the mark. And a loose ball foul is called there on Kawhi Larty. And Dalik Mingo will go to the line. Chance to make it a six-point ball game with 1:13 left to go in regulation. And Mingo knocks down the first free throw. Bison up five. Mingo squares up. Second free throws just off the rim. A&T clears the rebound. They bring the ball up. One away left to go in regulation. Gantz with the ball. He drives. He swings it to Boykins. And Boykins finds Femi Olujobi for the lay-in. And that pulls the Aggies within three with a minute. And we're back live, 1-on-1 left to go, minute one left to go in regulation. Howard with the basketball, up three. Trying to hold on for this victory. And earn it. And Cole swings it to Mingo. Mingo with the pull-up jumper, and he's fouled. 31.3 left to go in regulation. Howard up three. And Delique Mingo going to the line for two free throws and a chance to make it a two-possession game. Mingo's first free throw attempt is good. Howard up four. He lines up for the second free throw. And the second free throw is good. Howard up five, 31.3 seconds left to go in regulation. Aaron Embiid takes the inbounds for North Carolina A&T. And they call a timeout. Back live, A&T currently down five with 26.3 seconds left to go. McGowan's inbounds the ball. He finds Malik Gantz. Gantz swings it to Edmead. Edmead on the three ball. His three ball is good. Aggies are down two. And Howard is forced to call a timeout. With 19.9 seconds left to go. It is just a two-point lead for the Bison. Live, the Bison inbound the ball. They can't quite get it inbounds there. A near turnover there by the Bison. They want to be careful not to turn the ball over in this situation. They're only up 2 points, and they don't want to give the ball to A&T with a chance of the ball in the front court for the Aggies. And the inbound the ball, and it's stolen by the Aggies. And McGowan's lays it in with 15.3 seconds left to go. Howard inbounding the ball to Cole. He's trapped in the corner. He gets it to Nate Garvey. And they get it across to Foster. He goes coast to coast and lays it in. 5.1 seconds to go. And Boykins. And he finds McGowan's for another land. And we are tied at 73 with a tenth of a second left to go. And we are going to overtime, tied at 73. And we welcome you back to the Berg. As we get set to start the overtime period, is a wild 19 seconds to end the game. The two teams trading baskets. And a couple of huge baskets there by Devaris McGowan's, sandwiching a basket by Kyle Foster in what is one of the wildest finishes to force an overtime in college basketball. And we'll see which team is able to take that momentum and guide them and lead themselves to victory. And Howard wins the tab. It's cleared by RJ Cole. He brings it across the timeline. He swings it to the freshman, Zion Cousins. Cousins works it to CJ Williams. CJ Williams swings it over to Delik Mingo. Mingo back to Cole. Cole drives in the paint, finds Cousins. Cousins loot the ball. And it's Aggies basketball. Finds Langley. And the short jumper there is good by Ojobi. And the Aggies have taken the lead 75-73 with just over 4 minutes to go in overtime. And RJ Cole squares up for three and knocks it down. And that puts the Bison back up by one. Finds McGowan's. McGowan's repost, works against Cousins, and an offensive foul is called on McGowan's.
Thank you.
And Delete Mingo brings the ball up for the Bison. He's defended by Aaron Edmead. He swings the ball to CJ Williams. Williams working around a Cameron Lewis screen. Ball swung to Zion Cousins. Cousins gets the ball to RJ Cole. Cole attacks the basket. He loses a loose ball. Ball's on the floor. Ball going back to Howard. Foster with the inbound. And a five second call is called on the Bison. A big turnover with 3:03 left to go in this overtime period. McGowan's inbounds it to Langley. Langley brings the ball up. Taps the basket. And it's stolen by CJ Williams. Williams going 1-on-2, and he finishes at the rim. And CJ Williams with 18 points for the Bison. Aaron Edmead squares up for three. It's off the mark. Rebounded by Kyle Foster, and he's fouled. Olujobi. So with 2:32 left to go in this overtime period, the Bison currently lead the Aggies 78-75. And Kyle Foster going to the line for a pair of free throws. Chance to make it a two-possession game with 2.5 to go. Foster knocks down the first free throw. And Foster's second free throw rattles in. Howard up 80-75 with 2:32 left to go in regulation. Aaron Emmy with the ball brings it across the timeline. He swings it to Malik Gantz. Gantz with the ball down to McGowan's. McGowan's up against Dion Cutts. Swings to Edmead. And Edmead is off on a three. Getting out of by McGowan's, and he's fouled. McGowan's with another offensive rebound there, and that pulls Aggies within 3 points with 2:15 left to go in regulation. Downs will go to the line, chance to complete the three-point play. And he's off on the free throws, rebounded by Cameron Lewis. Gets it over to Cousins, and they get it over to Cole. And it's turned over by the Bison. And the Aggies will get the ball back. Thank you.
to the ball game for the Aggies, number 25, Jimmy Olivoli, and for the Heisman, number 0, Salif Mingo.
Edmund with the ball. He brings it across the timeline, defended by Cole, swings it over to McGowan's. He finds Malik Gantz. Gantz works the ball back to Olajuwon. Back to McGowan's. He finds Gantz. Gantz off on the shot. Rebounded by Delik Mingo. And Mingo brings the ball across the timeline, where he's trapped. Finds Zion Cousins to Arjit. And Zion Cousins with the rebound and the foul. Howard up 82-77, minute 32 left to go in regulation. And Cousins will go to the line with a chance to make it a 6-point game with a minute 32. And the freshman's good on the free throw. A huge free throw there for the Bison. Edmead takes the inbounds. Brings it across the timeline. He finds McGowan's at the top of the key. They swing it over to Boykins. Lardy with the ball, he swings to McGowan's. McGowan's attacks the basket. He loses the ball, swings out to Lardy. And RJ Cole secures the rebound. Basket, and he's fouled there by Lardy. 51.1 left to go in regulation. Howard up 6. And Cole heading to the line. He's off on the first free throw. And Cole is good on the second one. Howard up by 7 with 50 seconds left to go. Edmund brings the ball to the front court. And ANC turns the ball over. Big defensive stop there for the Bison. Mingo at the inbound, struggling to get it in, gets it into Cole. Cole with the pass, finds CJ Williams for the alley-oop. And that puts the Bison up 9 with 39 seconds in regular. But McGowan's with the easy basket at the other end. 36.5 left to go in regulation. They find the ball, RJ. And he's fouled on the attempted trap there by the Aggies. Howard up 86-79, 34.9 left to go in regulation. Cole at the line, and the first free throw rims out. And the second free throw is short, rebounded by McGowan's. He clears it to Edmead. Edmead for three. It's on the mark. Aggies within four with 27 seconds to go. And they trap CJ Williams. And a jump ball is called. Mingo struggling to get the ball in there. Knocked out of bounds by North Carolina NC. And with 24.8 seconds left to go in regulation, Howard currently leads the Aggies 86-82. Back live, Howard will inbound the ball. 24.8 seconds left to go. Delik Mingo is the inbounder. Gets it inbounds to Foster. Foster loses it out of bounds, and ANC will get the ball back with 23.6 seconds left to go. Down by 4 points. Timeout is taken there by North Carolina ANC with 23.6 seconds to go in regulation. are back live. Aaron Edmey will inbound the ball for North Carolina A&T. He finds the ball, it's turned over, and it's stolen by CJ Williams. Williams attacks the basket, and he's fouled at the other end with 19.1 seconds left to go. And CJ Williams will go to the line for two free throws and a chance to make it a two-possession game yet again. And Williams' first free throw is good. Bison up 87-82. And Williams knocks down the second for Bison up 88-82 with 19 seconds left to go. Edmey takes the inbound, pulls up for three. It's on the mark again. It is just a three-point game with 13 seconds. Mingo gets the ball in bounds, and he's fouled by Edmey. And Aaron Edmey has been really clutch in this second half in overtime. He's knocked down several huge three-pointers, and has just continued to give the Aggies life throughout this game. Let's see. And Delik Mingo will go to the line, shoot two free throws. 11.8 seconds left to go in regulation. And Howard with a chance yet again to make it a two-possession game with 11.8 seconds left to go in overtime. First free throw is good by the Mingo. He readies for the second free throw attempt. And the second one rattles in. Bison up 90-85, 11.8 seconds left to go. And the Aggies inbound the ball. And a foul is called. As number 15, Amari Hamilton got a good look at a three-point attempt and is fouled there by the Bison. Not what you want to do in that situation with 6.7 seconds left. It's foul a three-point shooter. And give them a chance to cut into this deficit again and make it a one-possession game. And Hamilton knocks down the first free throw. Lines up for the second one, and it is good. Howard's lead is just 3 points with 6.7 left to go. And he hits all three free throws, and that pulls the Aggies with a 90-88 with 6.7 seconds left to go. Delik Mingo inbounds the ball to RJ Cole. He's immediately fouled. And he'll go back to the line for two more free throws. And Cole's free throw is just short. And Cole will go back to the line for a second free throw. Chance to make it a three-point game with 6.1 seconds. And Cole's free throw is short. ANSU gets the ball 4 seconds. And a timeout is called by North Carolina ANSU. 2.4 seconds left to go. And they will have a chance to either win or tie this ball game in overtime. Back live, 2.4 seconds left to go in overtime. Howard up 90-88. North Carolina ANSU get the ball in the front court with a chance to win or tie this game. Hamilton with the inbound. He finds it Olajuwon. His jumper's off the mark, and Howard escapes with a victory, 90-88. What a great game there by the Bison. And this has been Noah Gooden with the Howard University Live Stream Sports signing off.
Defeating the North Carolina A&T Aggies in overtime. We absorbed all of the energy from the stands and we were able to get the job done. Tonight's high scores were RJ Cole with 23 points and CJ Williams with 22. With Spotlight Network, this is Marissa Watts.